this is a video response to ToastToGo. He did a video where he asked, how many miles have you ridden on your bike? And I don't know if he was saying like your current bike or totaling all the bikes you've had. And I know I'm not gonna win any freaking records or anything, because I haven't been riding that long. But anyway, I'm gonna tally up the bikes I've had. I had a ZZR 600 that I put about 8,500 miles on before I got rid of it. And then my XT250, I didn't have it very long. I think I put about 800 miles on that before I sold it. And then my WR250, I've had a little bit of trouble riding it just because of the seat height. Pay attention to the road, bitch. Playing with your cooch or whatever the fuck you were doing down there. Anyway, so by WR, I've probably put about, I don't know, 600, 700 miles on it so far. And about 200 of that was just the trip getting it home. But I have purchased a Corbin seat for it, which dropped, put my feet about 2 inches closer to the ground. And I'm gonna lower it just a little bit more. And then I think it'll be just about perfect. I'll probably start riding the shit out of that thing, because it's a lot of fun. But sometimes on the trails or on water crossings and things like that, it's really, I don't know, it just uncomfortable not being able to put my feet down. It just kind of freaks me out. And maybe once I get used to it, I'll raise it again. But some impatient motherfuckers. Can't wait just a minute for somebody to turn. Going off in somebody's fucking yard just to get around them. What a bunch of assholes. Anyway, the bike that I've ridden the most, of course, is the one I'm on now, my Gixxer. It only had 500 miles on it when I got it. The guy that owned it previously, apparently, he was in the military, and after he got out of the military, all his military friends had got motorcycles, so he went out and got one and rode it a couple of times, and I think he dropped it once and had a stop sign or something, and kind of freaked himself out, I guess, and decided it just wasn't his thing. So that's why I got such a really good deal on it. Because at the time, I think Gixxer 600 was about a $10,000 bike. And I got it for $7,200, I think, if I'm remembering correctly. And it only had 500 miles on it, so I mean, it was practically brand new. And let's see what we have now. Right now it has 13,340 miles on it. So all of that is was put on by me, except for like 500 miles. So let me tally all that up, and I really haven't ridden a whole lot. And most of the miles on this bike I put on last year. I really haven't had a chance to ride very much this year. It's either been really, really hot or really, really rainy, or both. We're definitely not having a drought here, because for most of the summer it seems like it's rained pretty much every day, at least for a little while. But I guess the longest trip I've ever done on it in one day. Well, I did a trip. Let's see, I did a trip that spanned about 4 days. I think it was about 4 days. I went from here up to Tennessee, rode over the Chiricahua Skyway, and then we rode into North Carolina and went out to the Outer Banks of North Carolina and went to a little island out there called Ocracoke. And then we rode back through South Carolina and Georgia. And on the last day, we went, I forgot the name of the city, I'd have to look at a map, but we went from kind of in the middle of North Carolina all the way back home to Birmingham in one day, in the rain. I think that was like a 680 mile trip, I think, or 680 miles, like that last day. The whole trip was much more than that, but that last day was about 680 miles. So, not exactly sure what the total mileage was, because I wasn't really adding it up in my head. But, and I don't want to do math right now. So later, I'll add it all up and put the total down in the corner of this video.